Hey guys, so for number 54, we're going to use the square root property to solve the equation. So here we have x plus 16 all squared minus 5 equal to 0. So what we're going to do is we're going to get the square, or everything that's being squared, by itself. So we're going to add 5 to both sides, leaving us with x plus 16 squared on one side, and then the 5 on the other. Now we're going to use the square root property. So we're going to go ahead and put a radical over the left-hand side and the radical over the right-hand side. And this works in our benefit because we're able to then just get rid of the square root and the square. So that leaves us with x plus 16 is equal to, so the square root of 5 actually translates into plus or minus the square root of 5. And then in order to complete this problem, we're going to separate it into two equations. So we're going to have x plus 16 equals positive square root of 5 on this side, and then x plus 16 equals negative square root of 5 on this side. And then we're just going to keep going. Now to get x by itself here, we're going to subtract 16 from both sides, leaving us with x equals square root of 5 minus 16. Now, I would always recommend putting this in the opposite order, just because it's more proper and there's less confusion going on, because this little square root can accidentally extend and that'll give us the wrong answer. So instead we're going to write negative 16 plus the square root of 5. And then on this side we're going to go ahead and subtract 16 from both sides again, leaving us with x equals, now I'm going to do the same thing, I'm going to rewrite this, instead of writing negative square root of 5 minus 16, I'm going to write negative 16 minus square root of 5. All right, so there is our answer.